So high unemployment, simultaneously not enough workers. But those aren't the only problems we're facing right now. The biggest problem may be in this nation, Barack and Michelle Obama are still oppressed. Yeah, even in Martha's Vineyard. On CBS this morning, Michelle Obama explained that she's just sick and tired of being sick and tired.
Many of us still live in fear as we go to the grocery store or worry about
walking
our dogs or allowing our children to get a license. I mean, just imagine, you know, you have a
Aren't
son
your girls
right
driving?
Now. They're driving. Yeah. But every time they get in a car by themselves, I worry about what assumption is being made by somebody who doesn't know everything about them. The fact that they are good students and polite girls, but maybe they're playing their music a little loud. Maybe somebody sees the back of their head and makes an assumption. I, like so many parents of black kids, have to, that the innocent act of getting a license mm-hmm. puts fear in our hearts.
She's more oppressed even than Meghan Markle is. Will someone liberate the Obamas? We can't elect them again. Time to liberate them. Candace Owens may do that. She's the host of Candace. She joins us tonight. Candace Owens, thanks so much for coming on. So if Michelle and Barack Obama are oppressed, if they live in fear, if this country's so bad that even the Obamas, elected president twice, can't live here, what is, I mean, is there a future? Should we leave?
I don't know, Tucker. I think we have to launch an investigation because I want to know which nanny, which chef, which housekeeper, which chauffeur, which Secret Service agent, which gardener, which landscaper is oppressing Michelle Obama, Barack Obama, and their children. I think we've got to get to the bottom of it at this point. I mean, I looked, and it looks like her net worth is about $70 million. Gayle King's is $40 million. Barack Obama and her combined is $135 million. Let me tell you something. If that's oppression, where can I get me some? I mean, so the back of people can look at the back of their head. You mean the Secret Service agents that are constantly around your children? They probably haven't even touched their own door handles in years. And we're supposed to believe that you're oppressed while the rest of the country is actually suffering? Please, Michelle Obama, give some of that oppression to the rest of America because we sure could use it.
Haven't touched their door handles in years. I'm stealing that. Why? I notice a theme here. There are a lot of extremely rich people who are deeply miserable and desperate to have you believe they're victims. What is that?
Yeah,
it's
great.
Unfortunate,
I mean,
to me.
LeBron James living in Bel Air, he's a victim. Meghan Markle went downgraded from billionaire to multimillionaire. She's a victim. They want you to know that they're all victims. It's because they're trying to distract us. The truth is that they view us as peasants. They're trying to make it seem like, hey, when the peasants turn against us because they're actually robbing all of them, we don't want them to look at us. We want to make them think that we're one of us. They're not one of us. They're nothing like us. They don't live like us. She has nothing that goes on in her life that is similar to the average American, yet she keeps trying to use her skin color and her complexion as a way to make people believe that she's suffering, and she's absolutely not suffering. And everyone should be aware that if you're watching this and you think that LeBron James and Meghan Markle and Barack Obama and Michelle Obama are oppressed, you are a fool. You have been fooled. They are doing just fine.
Just fine. I would say that's true. Candace Owens, so nicely put, as always. Thank you for coming on tonight. Great to see you.
Hey, Sean Hannity here. Hey, click here to subscribe to Fox News YouTube page and catch our hottest interviews and most compelling analysis. You will not get it anywhere else.